So I've got this drop here. It's got a pretty good crack in the end. You know, there's not really much I can do with something that long. And then this board here, this is a really, got that really funky mineral color to it. It's not really very pretty at all. And you can see all these big cracks and checks in it. So I'm gonna take one that mates with this here, and then I'll take two more, whatever I can get out of this. And I'm just gonna go ahead and, you know, I'm gonna glue these together, flatten them and glue them together. So I'm gonna do one here, and then I'll take this one and I'll make one more larger one. Okay, so I've decided that I'm gonna make two sections. I've got the piece with that cutout on it. That I'll cut a little drop off this end, and then I'm gonna cut this in half and make one more, because I'm gonna glue them together. But before I cut this apart, I think I'm gonna go ahead and join it and run it through the planer, just because a board about this size is really easy to manage, and I won't have any snipe running through my planer or anything like that. So let me deal with that. I'll get this straightened out and cleaned up. And that other board over there, you can see it's so wonky, I don't want to try to cut it on the table saw, because it's just rocking so bad. So I need to straighten that out too, and get it flattened out before I try to cut it down to length. On second thought, I'm gonna go ahead and drop this end off, because this thing has such a weird kick here that by the time I got it straightened out, I'd end up having to take about a quarter of an inch off. And the way it drops and kicks right there is about where I need to cut it. So let me just go ahead and get rid of that junk right now. A lot of times with weird things like this, I do these in two passes so I don't get something bound on me. When I pass these boards, whenever you have a short board like this to your planer, if you just kind of push it straight in here where the feed rollers hit the edge parallel, that's when you can get it to dip. But if you put it in like this where the feed rollers grab one corner of it first, so if you put it in at a skew and then let it straighten itself out, you'll get a much better cut without the snipe. Just a little trick I learned a long time ago. It's always best to kind of start them start all your boards at an angle and then straighten them out. So see, even in this these short boards, there's no snipe. You know, so you start it, instead of like this, where it can kick it, it just grabs a corner and then brings it through real nice. Okay, I'm ready to glue these guys up, and I'm gonna race because it's hotter than a $2 pistol in Texas today. So I don't have much time with these, so I'm gonna do one at a time. A lot of my rapid action clamps are tied up with another setup, so I can't use those, so I'm gonna use mostly these hand screws. I have them already pre-made or pre-set up to the right dimensions, so I don't have to fumble with it. And I had a spreading stick, if I can figure out what I did with it. Here, I'll just get in this bucket and get it out of there. And I'll show you the annual ring setup after I get this glued up. And I don't care if I get a little bit of glue on my Rabot, because this has got plenty of finish on it and it'll just peel right off that finish. It won't stick to the water locks. But whenever I do glue ups like this, I always make sure I really smear the glue deep into the wood fibers. Type on 3, and this sets up really, really fast in the heat. Too fast, really. You can't get ahead of yourself with this stuff. But it's awesome glue. And I love the color, too. I wish they had a little bit slower set, but with this nice tan brown color, which is a real nice look, instead of that ugly yellow color that so many aliphatic resin glues are. Work really good just to stop that squishing. I could use about 10 more of these rapids. They're just the no better clamp in the world than those things.